Columbus Highway, LR 34. Thank you. Hold on. Corvallis Newport Highway. Alert 34 by.
You're there, right?
Continue on this road for 46 miles.
S20. my guide. Turn left in 600 feet. In 500 feet, turn left on East Slope Road. Turn right, and then turn left in 600 feet. In 400 feet, turn left on East Slope Road.
Go, party peeps. Made it to our company, customer rather. I gotta drop this trailer and pick up another load out of here. So, all right, so there we go. Highway 20, westbound from I-5 there. Here's let's say Highway 34 to Highway 20. Party peeps, we'll do it again next week. Stay tuned. At the rear end, I guess. United States Railway Post Office. Gotta hurry, it's starting to sprinkle. $500 camera can't get wet. So this appears to be a little yard engine, I guess they called it. Pushes things around. Just around the yards. I don't know, I just walked on it. I walked across. I don't know. Don't ask me. I guess I look like a conductor. I don't know. Southern Pacific. See, you're not really, most people don't walk over here. See, I do unusual things. I do things that your average bear does not do. Go to the front door, I go to the back of the lot, right? I do this. That's what we did last time. I just felt comfortable doing it. I hear the alarm going off. Whoop, 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 whoop. Oh, there's a cafe right here. Is it open? So we live streamed this last time I was here. I don't know how. I mean, I guess I could know if I went back to the live stream and looked at it, but I don't. This I know for sure is going to be a lot better clarity for you guys and for me. I wanted to come back and redo it on GoPro, so some kind of switch machine, I think. The crane they use to, I guess, set the tracks and the timbers, what do you call them? Sleepers. Sleepers are these little timbers down there. Okay, so this is what I wanted to get more clarity for you guys, because last time I came here on a live stream, you know, I was looking at these soapstone marks. They got everything grids on this thing, and I think Somebody said they possibly were doing testing the iron. It's probably cast iron, and they're testing the integrity of it and whether it is safe to, whether or not it's safe to try to build steam in this boiler ever again. And it's been retired so long. See all the little rusty spots where they tested it with the x-ray or whatever they used? And it looks like it's been, they haven't made a decision yet as far as let's get it back in service or not. So this is the coal car, I believe. And there should have been a place to burn the coal to make the steam and make the power, make it go. And I'm happy that they preserved it. Okay, private property, please feel free to look, but stay off. So we can look. Okay, as long as we don't climb on it, I think we're okay. Not gonna do that. The Baldwin Locomotive Works, Philadelphia. Cool, man. I never really cared about trains, and then, you know, because you see them all the time, and what's the big deal? But there's a whole genre of people out there that love trains. And so I made a train playlist on my channel here, and what are you going to do? I'm kind of enamored by them myself after all these years. A lot of steel and iron goes into it. And looking at these welds too. They don't look so good, do they? Part of that is you got your foreman yelling at you, that's good, that's all you need. And you, the welder, may have the idea that you want to put a welder, better weld, but your boss is yelling at you to hurry up. Anyway, let's see if this Caboose Cafe, are they open today? No? I don't think
they're
so.
Open up here. It's a great place to visit.
No, the cafe for food?
Oh, that I don't know.
Oh, okay.
But this is a great place to visit.
Okay, I'll check it out. Look, and I remember there's something in here that talks about restoration. So they restored it. Disconnects. What the heck is a disconnect? Logging disconnects circa 1914. Disconnects were popular with logging chained and swiveled to swivel bunks and hauled through tight curves. And so a disconnect is helps it to timbers. You can read all this. I'm just reading it very quickly. One spot with disconnects going to another. Okay. So this is a disconnect that's been restored and repaired. I love this old snap tie. What do you call them? We still use them today. Chain binder, called a binder. And still use them today, although they're falling out of popularity because they are dangerous. And a lot of truck drivers have lost their teeth, broke their arm, or busted their face when they're trying to unsnap them. And so they come up with this thing where you can, it has threads on it, and you screw it down. I'm talking here, bird. All right, I just wanted to get a picture of this train. I don't want to go in the museum, I don't think. I'm looking for food also. Let's see. Face coverings. Check out this old lamp here. Lantern. Want some old jacks? Check some oil cans. Is this a bicycle or something? So it looks like you put your feet here and your hands here and you just make it go. That would be a heck of a workout. And they have different examples of size of tracks. These are very small, tiny, compared to hand-cranked track drill. Used to drill holes in rails for attaching connecting plates to join two rails together. Most standard rails came pre-drilled. Often, however, yard track was of multiple lengths. So, had to drill, and it looks like it drills sideways into the, I want to say the web of the track over there, so you can bolt your, connect your two tracks together. And so what I'm going to, here's what I call it. This part here is the web. This is be the flange, and this would be the flange, but I don't know what they call it. That's what I call it, so it won't go by me. Some kind of a pallet jack, but except it doesn't have forks on it. It's got a little platform on it. Cool, man. Got some stuff. Oh, shit. Scared me. Very cool, man. Fireproof foam up there. I wonder if that's the same one out front or not. Love that trestle. Southern Pacific. Some old luggage. Oh, look at this bell. Trunks. Very cool, man. Spikes. Old gem locks. Old-time remote control from the 1800s. Check out this TV. I think beyond here is Memorial Library. Can we get back there or no? I'm not sure if this is accessible. Very cool, man. I like the old bells. Keep them out of the weather, huh? And we work with these in my trade, a PV and a, they're called a cant hook in the dictionary, but we use those, move logs around. Pilings, wood pilings, or basically a utility pole that you see pile drivers turn them upside down, the skinny end down, and drive them in the ground. All kinds of information here for railroad buffs to come along and read this stuff. Hmm.
This looks like the road we came up in. Blodgett? That was one of the towns we went through coming here. Mailbag when train passes. Now, I've seen in Japan, I don't know if they still do it, but how they would deliver the mail is they'd have a person hanging out over here, and as the train went by, they would grab the mailbag when the train was in motion. Look at all this information you gotta read. I'm not gonna take a picture of each one, but each one of the, you gotta come here and read this stuff. Looks like they're using that as offices right now. Gift shop and office. Oh, okay. Can we go in? I don't really want to go in, do I? Just want to take a picture. Yeah. No, I won't go in. They look like they're eating lunch. Feel good yourself? I'm just delivering a load over here to GP, and I was walking around.
Oh, I see. You don't want a tour.
Last time I came here, I walked around, and I thought I wanted to revisit because I was doing a live stream, and it's nice. Very pixelated, so I thought I'd bring my GoPro this time.
Yeah,
it's crystal clear.
That's really cool.
No, I don't really have time for a tour, but maybe next time.
Do you want to sign our guest book, though?
Sure.
That would be awesome.
Sure, absolutely. I appreciate the not calling the cops on me.
Say hi to a little mascot. I have my dog with me.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah, come on in. So it's right there.
Look at the puppy.
I appreciate that.
Hi, puppy.
He needs to say hi if anyone,
of course. Hi, puppy. Here's the welcome wagon.
Yes.
Oh. My audience, they love dogs.
Nice.
I got a pen.
Perfect. Thank you. I appreciate it.
What's the date today? 28?
26.
20?
Oh, wait.
27, I think.
Yeah, 27. Time flies.
I don't know.
I think so. Yes, you.
Truck driver. Oops, can't spell. I came down here years ago. I used to drive with my dog on my truck, and we toured on the leash. We walked down here and saw it with my eyes.
Yeah.
And later on, I became a YouTuber, and I thought, I can't just look at something. I got to preserve it for all time, for all everybody.
Nice.
So, yeah, I just like to document things. Yeah. I also film my driving and stuff like that, so.
Nice.
All right, well, appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Coming to say hi. Hi, puppy. What's your name, puppy?
Daja.
Ah, very nice.
That's my login.
Yes, you did. Yeah.
Yeah, I got it. All right, thank you. We'll see you next time.
Okay, take care.
All right, there you go, pretty peeps, very nice. I think I want to get something to eat, though. Let's go around this way. Is it a dead end? Dead end. Wait a minute, I saw something here.
Great, but I just
wanted to
catch up with you really quick.
Centennial clock. Like I said, we saw this stuff last time, however. It was very pixelated, so I wanted to return. Oh, look at this. This is open. Okay, since we're here, I know somebody will say, Scotty, why didn't you just go in there? Show us that. So this is cool. I guess this is where you sit and you run your controls. Very cool, man. Operating guide. Diesel electric. 45 ton, 300 horsepower. So it's got all kinds of information here. You guys got it. If you're a train buff, you need to come here actually in person and see this stuff. Very cool. 65 years old, 45 tenor, affectionately called the Loki by mail workers and railroaders, is a gift from Georgia Pacific. How do you like that? There it is. Very cool, man. They got a lot of work out of this thing in its lifetime. I like it. I love it. It appeared to be no air conditioning in there, so you gotta... Did it have a heater? I think that's the heater right there or something. Probably. Or is that some kind of battery charger? I'm not sure. Surely they had a heat in here for the winter, but maybe not air conditioning. Hardcore, man. I believe that might be the horn right there, huh? Cheer, cheer! All right, I gotta find something to eat. How do you like the nails for the pistols? Oh, you know what? That's the post office. Somehow I thought that was the railroad museum, but no, that's the post office. Totally remember that now, because the first time I came in here, I came here years and years ago with Swift, when I was a Swift driver with my dog, and had better directions or something, or maybe I was just a smarter dude, and I didn't, but the last time I came here, I drove in here, and it's a dead end right here, with my tractor trailer, and I got in a bad, bad spot trying to turn around, man. It was a mess. And so now I remember that is the post office. And this is a dead end. Trying to remember what I did. Came in, I couldn't turn around, there were a bunch of cars in here. I had to pull up there and back into this driveway right here, sort of. And it was very, very complicated. I had to back in here and then head out that way and get out of my mesh. So this appears to be some kind of block shiv. Yeah, some kind of crane block of some sort, looks like. It's got a shiv right there, sheave, S-E-H-E-A-V-E, shiv, we pronounce it. And so one of these days, if I really have time and I get retired, I would do this walking tour. There's so much to see in this little town. I remember walking my dog. I had a 10-hour break here and we just walked around town a bit, but like I said, now I am a YouTuber, I gotta film things. So what are you gonna do? Old time anchor. All right, time to go eat. Oh, there's a little write-up right here, let's see. I'll add all this. I think I just put it on the end of that driving video. What do you think? People who stick around for the end get the bonus. One Spot, the steam locomotive known as One Spot, retains its original number one from June 1922 when it was delivered to the Baldwin Locomotive Works in Philadelphia to Toledo, Oregon. The engine is a 90-ton superheated steam boiler type 282 wheel configuration with a 50-ton tender for fuel, oil, and water. So it didn't use coal, it used fuel oil and water for steam, I guess. And the driving wheels are 44-inch diameter. She employed for many years in the logging service along the coast in South County in 1936. When Camp 1 near Yakutsk was shut down, The C.D. Johnson Lumber Company acquired a move the engine to this area, continuing to run the reliable steamer in its logging operation between Seilitz area and Toledo. One Spot spent her entire career hauling logs from the forests of Lincoln County. After her retirement by Georgia Pacific in 1959, the engine was put on permanent display in Toledo. Now under ownership and caretaking of the local railroad historical society, it is hoped that this icon of the region's railroad heritage can be rescued from the further ravages of time. And understand, it's nearly 100 years old. Yeah, the ravages of time. So they keep it, certainly keep the rain off of it. Still, you know, it's getting assaulted by mother, father time, I'll say. All right, so there's one more thing to look at right here. A couple more things. Set of trucks. Age unknown, or is this the way they still make them, or is this an antique set from the olden days? We don't know. I always wanted to take a look at this. Is this, see how do they connect the axle to the frame here? Is it bolted or is it just gravity? That's what I don't know. It doesn't appear to be any connection unless you count this clip right here, some kind of steel clip. I'm not sure how that connects. These two connect to each other. And this here looks like just a piece of artwork that somebody has twisted up.